This episode of The General's Gentleman is sponsored by Offworld Trading Company, a truly innovative RTS focused on market manipulation, advanced economic management, and corporate sabotage. Profit from the life support needs of the colonists and bankrupt your friends in the process.
Welcome to The General's Gentleman.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the fields of Colodny Firma Winter.
On these fields today, we'll be SOE Swim Panther, so Wehrmacht,
and spawning as our British, wearing the red trunks, Ihiso.
I wonder if that's, I guess a anglicized version of his actual name, which is written in the characters to the left, which I'm not even going to guess which kind of language that is, so.
Oh, where he's like, actually, my name is Doe, but the white barbarians call me Ihiso.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what I'm thinking. I'm not sure.
Ihiso going for the triple infantry sections, no Vickers in sight. This is a nice capping order as well here, where you send your first squad forward to get behind the heavy cover and cap that muni point. No.
Where's your stop micro at, bro?
This game is over. We can stop casting now. This is obviously exit, a wash. Yeah. I don't want to cast
complete
these
wash.
Noobs.
Hero's out. Make a mistake once, the General's Gentleman will forgive you. Make it twice and we'll stop casting your game. Perhaps he can pull it back. You never know.
And a very fast sniper for Sturm Panther. This isn't a really good map for it, but British are fundamentally flawed as a faction and thus don't have any ways to counter the sniper because they have four-man squads, their fire on the move is awful, they don't have any close-range weaponry. The Bren carrier doesn't work because Panzerfausts, so, you know, I can get on board with that.
Just a few reasons.
I might be a bit of like, I'm sorry.
Bro, not even.
I mean,
even
it's
worrying.
The truth, though. It's like,
yeah.
It's not a balance.
It's a bit
problem.
Of truth. There's not
it's,
an issue with speaking
flaw.
The bit of truth. And there goes a quarter of your squad's DPS. Good luck doing anything to the MG. The retreat was a good move.
I mean, giving them better farm-the-move accuracy would certainly help, but the sniper needs a bit more than that. The sniper to be weaker. At least in the next patch, the Winter Balance preview, the sniper's cloak is being nerfed, which is going to be a very, very nice change.
This is kind of a little bit unfortunate for... Oh, got the garrison!
Oh, you'll get it. Oh, maybe not! Oh, man! He hit the snow.
Too late.
You know how deep snow still exists?
Kind of, just in some areas it just exists.
Like that icon, like, why is that icon there? Is that actually, like... deep snow that shouldn't exist.
Yeah.
It probably is.
I'm pretty sure that's the thing, though. That always has been a problem. With that being said, the MG42 probably going to be wiped here. That's another model going down. Going to be careful with the infantry sections that close. The sniper takes one damage. Actually going to reface, try to look for the double suppression here while the sniper's still firing.
Vickers started hitting the sniper. That was a bit of a mistake there. And the MG actually make it out here. Wow. It's good play here from Stern Panther.
Yeah, that was quite nice.
Yeah,
finding suppression on both infantry sections.
What would have happened is when they removed deep snow, they probably just went back into the map editor and just, like, removed the deep snow manually. But, like, it's still there. And I know on Samosi too, there's a few cases. I think even the team game maps too.
Now, what happened is they tasked Harold with removing the deep snow from every single map, and he got really salty, so he just left it in a couple of places. Maybe it was Stormless who did it. Maybe they tasked Stormless with removing deep snow, and then he just left
he
it in.
He secretly sabotaged it.
Just in a few places around doors, just so he knows it's still there.
Because I know you can still get cold tech, like blizzards and freezing. Mm. If you play on a custom game, you can enable that. But deep snow, I'm assuming, was just manually removed from the map.
Okay.
So now we're going to have Ihiro. He's on his tier 2 now. He has a squad of the Royal Engineers. I'm assuming he'll go for a sniper because it's really the only way you can take the sniper out. Hopefully there wasn't too many people that were butthurt when I said that you can't counter the sniper. But you can counter the sniper quite literally with a counter sniper. And I definitely need a mortar though from Stern Panther, so that's interesting. I guess he wants to clear that MG out of the house.
Yeah. Probably going to be it. We're not wanting to invest in the Pioneer Flamer, so... Mortar can be nice. Infantry section's also obviously wanting to fight at long range as much as possible. Mortar will hopefully be turning some of the engagements in the favor of the Grenadiers in conjunction with the Wehrmacht sniper.
Who do you think will win, Blake?
Look, the Sturm Pioneers with their SMGs, or the infantry section behind cover, looking super swaggy with rifles, is definitely going to be the Pioneers.
They can probably win if they run up and start planting S-mines. Like, you think I'm joking, but it's actually not that much of an exaggeration.
I want to see someone try and do that sometime. I know we joke about planting S-mines in combat, but I want to see someone, like, actually pull that off against the only damage squad, just plant an S-mine at their feet, walk away and just watch them blow it up or something. So, suppose the issue is you finish the S-mine and then it blows up your squad as well as it blows up the enemy squad. But yeah.
So we have the Flamer Engineers, Aihiro already locking in the Mobile Assault Regiment. Sturm Panther in desperate need of a med bunker. Getting his tier 2 now. He can actually afford a med bunker. He should go for that one.
Yeah. Real easy to invest. You're not going to be going for the early Pioneer Flame. You've got those early munitions that you need to spend on that medical bunker.
It doesn't matter. He has 160 munitions.
Yeah.
Do whatever
well, that's
want,
what I mean. He could have gone a lot earlier. That was an option. So that sometimes does hamstring the Wehrmacht player if they go for early munitions investments because of how expensive things like Teller Mines or the Flamer Package obviously are. But yeah, as you say, you know, we're 6 minutes into the game. It's not really a big issue now.
Well, it's also because he had double munis point. I didn't quite realize that. Mm. He's had these both for a while, and it's always very, very powerful if you can get a lot of munis as Wehrmacht. They do scale the best, I think, with munis. I guess maybe apart from US, they just get, like, crazy bar blobs. Depends. But they might have a lot of tools which they can use. The mines are at least can be very impactful.
Not actually a counter snipe here. It's going to be an AEC from Aihiro.
Oh, and yeah, and a 222 as well. So
heavy armored car ready. A capture point is being overrun.
He's got two Grenadiers squads, so he can get two LMGs. Still will have a lot of munis left over from that. Also have to be careful of the infiltration commandos. They will be coming up soon as an option.
More having to be careful. Real prioritization into the 2-2-2 coming out. That's going to turn out to be an intelligent move from Sturm Panther that will deny the manpower that he needs for medical bunker.
Sturm Panther's in a bit of a rough spot here because he doesn't have enough manpower for a pack, and he just bought his med bunker, just bought his 222. Right now, he doesn't have any counters to this AEC. He could even just base dive the scout car. If he gets really cocky, he could actually kill this med bunker too. Yeah. No, he's about to out. I mean, he's got to be expecting a pack.
Glad at least the 222 is there. The danger is having the mortar or the sniper dive without the 2-2 there would have been pretty huge. At least it makes the AEC think twice. Wouldn't be able to dive those infantry squads. If we hadn't seen the 2-2-2, probably would have just run in and, you know, potentially eaten a Faust.
Yeah. The thing is with the AEC is the turret rotation's actually really slowly. Yeah. So you can get those flanks with that 2-2-2 and just keep circling it and kill it. If you're able to do that flank. But if you don't flank it, you're just going to get destroyed from the front.
Yeah.
But double fuel there for a while as well. Sturm Panther's pushed off for now, but he's had pretty good income of resources. His squads are healed up now. He's on his way to get a pack. I mean, he could even go for Shreks if he wants to, given his munitions.
Looking towards our victory points. Sturm Panther, the man suffering. 376 compared to the full 500 from Aihiro. Yeah, so cost for the early munitions point control. Sturm Panther.
So it's the British sniper being built. Generally, you'll see that pretty early on, a lot earlier than this, which is why this 2-2-2 is pretty important to try and dive that sniper down. And Sturm Panther, I mean, even looking at his fuel, he actually has a lot of options here. He could even go for a pretty quick tier 3, but he's going for that pack now. That'll at least give him the option to try and force away the AEC.
Just double checking, we are on live, aren't we? I didn't ask you before the game, but we are on live, so.
Yeah, the AEC wouldn't be murdering the Grins that quickly. They were negative cover, to be fair, but the AEC's anti-infantry is actually really good in live, despite being an anti-vehicle. Okay, the sniper's revealed himself. Not wasting any time here, not looking for a hidden counter sniper. I like that. I always get so triggered when I see people not reveal a sniper for 10 minutes, and it's like, okay, we get it. You're trying to counter snipe, but you could have killed like 200 manpower worth models by now.
My counter snipe sensors are they're tingling machine.
Good news. The ability is ready for use.
I'm not sure if Aikido saw Storm Panther's sniper take cover. I'm pretty sure it did.
Dunno.
We're chilling at each other's ranges, both. Okay. Oh, wow, if the AC gets the reveal on the sniper.
But the AC's detection range, I don't think it's too good. The scout car will have more detection range. Oh, is he going for a pioneer? Uh-oh. No, he's on hold fire. Okay, that's good.
Trying to take one of our points.
Man, this is Bola.
Is he looking for the MG? What's around? Okay, the scout car's going forward, so the pack's there as well, actually. Could even lose that to this AEC, I mean. The pack? What is he doing? Oh, no!
Oh, he's not moving!
Did he get caught on that house? He didn't micro that very well. AEC goes down. But Aikido, he took the entire map during that. This pack could get hit by the infiltration commanders if he cancels the six-pounder. Even the mortar, too.
The Huns have 300 points at the moment.
Storm Panther. Not moving the Vermax sniper, that's really bad.
Oh
here we go!
Okay, he's got the incendiary as well here.
Go on!
Oh, he's a little bit late! Just out of the range! Okay, the Tommies reveal him, and the Vic is in the house. No, just the engineers, in fact, are gunning him down, and the sniper dies, Stern Panther immediately replacing that. The Tommies is surprised they revealed him as far away as they did.
It's really unfortunate. They're not quick enough on the trigger to find the counter snipe. Had a lot of opportunity to find it as well.
Oh, I could actually lose a Grenadier squad here. I know, he was quite far away. Yeah, that was a great play by Aikido. He's still looking good in the map control. Has the VPs going well in his favor. He doesn't have his tier 3 yet, but that one should be coming soon.
You just don't expect the sniper to still be there. Aikido had no presence in the center of the map around that victory point, but he stayed in cover until he was threatened, and he just wasn't threatened during that engagement. This is look at that MG42 crew placement.
Whoa, I wish my MG was always like that.
How great would it be?
Yeah, it's actually a great way of getting those counter snipes is just leaving it really deep in enemy territory. It's risky as you saw, but sometimes your opponent will just slip up and put the sniper out in the open because they assume that, oh, well, they won't be around here. This scout car could actually die here. I think not quite one shot, but he'd certainly be close.
Is the sniper going to shoot?
He's probably not within vision here. Yeah, there we go. Nah, it's just not quite the full attack range as vision.
Just see a Vermax sniper rebuilt as well, so I'm going to be back on counter snipe watch.
Whoop, that was Aikido's vision. Yeah. He saw that.
Yeah.
At least he could have seen it. Maybe he didn't. Oh my god, look at this.
Come on, this Sniper's is such a big opportunity. Surely. Good stuff. The rebuild surprises Aikido.
Look at the veterancy of the sniper. Oh, the mini-map's blocking it. Webcam, I mean. But it's like almost vet one. Just that single shot from the sniper.
Pretty insane.
Okay, that pack's a little bit too deep here.
I'm just capping a victory point. Wants to join in on the fun. Help the game get one. Storm Panther on 226 VPs. You know, despite having recently lost his snipers, still on the full 500. Storm Panther has a lot of work to do if he wants to get back into this game.
So you know how last cast, the Love Nest versus Wuff game, we had this long rant about the MG arc inside houses?
Yeah, yeah.
Someone pointed out that if you select the HMG specifically, apparently it reveals the arc, like the actual arc. And I did it just then, and the arc changed. I don't know if it's still accurate or not, but I'll show you again when he's in the house again.
Okay, cool.
The arc on the house is different to the arc when you select the MG specifically.
Right.
Which could... Oh, wow, that's a Stoogie. Okay, yeah, got two.
Not so a Stoogie. Don't worry, Mission. Yeah. Callum, your senses haven't taken leave.
Have you seen the new Stoogie in the Winter Balance preview?
Yes, I have. Yeah. The Brumbari.
Yeah, the mini Brumbari. Yeah. It's quite fun. There's no anti-tank here at all. Oh, just kidding, there's a six-pounder right there.
Nice joke.
Yeah, this MG could go down.
Tree, no.
Was that a, seriously a-
What?!
Oh my god.
That was god. A wipe. I'll take a Brumby E any day, thank you. Triggered!
Alright, counter snipe.
Scott wasn't even low. Not even low.
Yeah, oh man. Yeah, the new Brumbar still has really good AoE, but its damage isn't enough to one-shot models at full health.
So the sniper takes a shot at the pack. It's a pretty big good bait, because if the sniper takes one shot here...
Yeah, but he can't fire over the hedge. Is that what you meant?
He might flank around. Sniper flanks anyway. Yeah, I believe Aikido sees that's a bait. I was thinking he was going to move the Vermark sniper up and get ready for a counter snipe, because a pack on three models is just too juicy of a target to pass up.
I don't know if he has cover here, though. Like, if that actually would count.
Pretty sure he does. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can get cover along the edge of that hedge. And obviously, a lot more easily on one model than you can try to get a whole squad to take cover along that hedge.
Right. Okay, so the 6-pounder's decrewed. Oh, the Stugi.
There's a second one. Stugi wasn't expecting that.
He can probably take one more shot, though.
There we go. Snipers on either side of the hedge here.
It has it's like... It's more than three shots worth. It's like 500 or 540 or something. We're also lowering its health to 480.
Okay, second 6-pounder probably going to be wiped here. It is indeed. Second 6-pounder goes down.
So, Stern Panther should really try and destroy these if he can. He already has two packs, so he doesn't need to cap them. He just needs to destroy them.
Yeah, definitely. No real point having a third AT gun. Unless he just goes full Stugi spam and then wants to have a bit of support there, but... Yeah, destroying them makes the most sense, and one of them certainly is well in destruction range, and the Stugi will be firing at it.
It's been a while since we've seen this commander. He bounced. Okay, the HMG will get recrewed. I think we've mainly been casting OKW lately. I think that's why.
Yeah.
And... Or we've been casting, like... Ostrapen or something. I know Hans doesn't go this commander normally. Enemy down to 200
points. No, I haven't seen a lot of it.
But it is the best strong. Commander in the game. Yeah. Like for 1v1, that is, hands down. Hmm. It had the highest pick rate, at least, in the Warpaint Championship. Yeah. Damned enemies trying to take a point from us. You know, you can certainly deny that Vermax are the strongest faction in the game, but the strongest commander by far. So you have the Stugi, so you don't have to tech. You have the Tiger, so you have good late game. You have the Arty, so you can destroy AT guns. It's crazy.
Squad right half track's in a really good spot as well. If you have the manpower to invest in that direction, they can get a lot of work done.
My favorite thing is seeing the Mad Dog half track, which is where you put two Shreks inside it and just go around circling after SU-76s. Now capture point. They're
trying to take it. Yeah, it has a lot of uses, but...
Okay, tier 3's up. No Cromwell just yet, despite the fuel. Is he actually going to go for a Cromwell, though? Because he knows the Stugi. The Stugi is Vet 2. He may want to go for a Firefly right up, just knowing that there's going to be a target coming up soon. And there's already two packs, so again, a Cromwell might not be the best thing here. Which is surprising, because you pretty much are always worth going Cromwell spam. Mm. They're just so good across the board.
He's not really going to have the fuel to be able to go land mattress into the Firefly either. It's going to be too much investment before the Tiger comes. Depending if he knows that. I mean, it is only 40, but 40 could end up mattering at this stage in the game.
A lot of munitions, too, for Aihito. So he's going to have some very strong Bren transitions once he gets that weapon racks. Oh, negative cover deluxe. Oh, no, what is What? What? Why did he retreat?
I have no idea. That must be right on the edge.
What the hell?
Oh, no. That must be right on the edge of going one direction or the other. We've seen that before, but I don't think we've ever seen it that bad.
Because, so, the way retreats work is it goes the shortest direction, but it will avoid units generally. So it won't go the shortest direction if there is X amount of units in the way, but... That was weird, man. This house is actually low too. You could get blown up.
Sniper firing at it as well.
This is Cromwell being built. Oh, Incendiary got a wipe.
A Nice.
Infantry section wiped out.
It's rough.
We're coming up. Not fun at all. Yeah, this grenadier needs to get out of the garrison. Yeah, that's the retreat. Doesn't want to risk taking another sniper shot. It is on hold fire, but...
We're losing a capture point.
Okay, Cromwell on the field. Land mattress now an option. But land mattress won't really help him that much. Because it's the Stugi that's the problem here. Yeah.
That's going down.
Whoops. Pack out of position as well. The other pack way down here. Is there a telemine? Misplay there, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, ends up going out of control anyway. Cromwell's are fast and it was along the road. Yeah, in that situation, the stop move is fine to try and get that last shot off, but you have to wait until the reload comes through. So you wait until the reload's through when you're about to shoot, you then stop, so you get that additional accuracy and get the shot off. Stopping prematurely means you're firing at a longer range, so... you obviously won't have the opportunity to go back on the chase should the shot miss.
So there's two decrude AT guns here. It looks like it's going to be easier for Ihito to cap them rather than for Sternpanth. The sniper's going to be flanked by the Tommies, and this HMG team will go down here. So a lot of dead support weapons.
Could be the sniper going down here as well. There's no preemptive retreat, and it has been revealed as well. There's the retreat, but it could be a little bit too late. The criminal's going to chase this one down.
Okay, that's a light arty barrage, but too late. HMG stolen. Cromwell couldn't quite get the sniper, and the Tiger's now being deployed. But what a massive swing for Ihito. He's going to get two AT guns, one AT gun off of Sternpanther, a wipe on the Pioneers. Jeez.
That is a huge swing. Sternpanther all of a sudden down to a pack, a sniper, a Pioneer squad, a Grenadier squad, and one Tiger. Still on 50 pop cap, but to the 61 of Hito with a fair bit of reinforcing work to do.
Was that a wipe? I think that was a wipe. There's only two Tommies.
Tommies?
Yeah, the Tommies were capping a point. So all of a sudden, he got wiped, but that was actually, he was on the point, so it was very clumped up. So, what do we say, Blake? What do we say?
Don't right click on points.
Don't right click on points. Yeah. Unless you know you won't get attacked. But if you're doing it near combat, the squad will clump up like that, and it's not good. That's good. Sternpanther, he needed that wipe, but he's still looking like he's in a pretty rough spot. Ihito doesn't have a great late game commander. Like, if he had something like the balance cover, or just the vanguard for the strafes, there's a lot of good support powers that British have, but, mobile assault, whatever the fuck it's called, mobile, I don't even know, dude, mobile assault regiment is not going to be the best.
107 VPs for Sternpanther compared to the 456 of Ihito, however. It's going to be really tough for Sternpanther, especially with this low squad count, to hold multiple VPs at this stage in the game.
There could also be some very decisive infiltration commandos. Say if there's a tense battle and there's a pack next to a house, and you just pop out, blow up the pack, and then all of a sudden the Tigers are without support. Mm. So there's always the potential for that. Like, I feel like a lot of things, if I was just to say, this commander isn't good late game, that's not quite true. That's being a little bit oversimplifying it. And Ihito can afford another tank in terms of fuel.
This could be another wipe. Oof. Oh, that guy just got was well out of position. Not really sure what Stumpanther's doing that far afield when he's so low in squads.
There's actually not that many mines on the field. Oh yeah, that was too deep for sure. Because your opponent has so much resources, it doesn't matter if you deny resources at this stage.
A mortar. At least that's gonna get away.
Hey, Arty Barrage, his sniper actually walks into it. Pack is... Oh, it's a counter snipe. That was a counter snipe.
It was a counter snipe. Wow.
I was like, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. I thought it wasn't an Arty shell. You're right. So that was well spotted.
And then the pack died. I don't know if that was an Arty shell or not.
Yeah, it might have been the Arty shell. So that was actually, that was very well spotted, Callum. Very well spotted.
Trying really hard to say Callum, not machine, aren't you?
I'm trying so hard, man. Thank you for I really appreciate that you're saying that, because I'm trying so hard. It really is a conscious effort at this stage. I'm throwing away every other casting practice that I'm doing at the moment and just working on calling you Gallum and not Machine.
It's true. It's my name.
Yeah.
I have one of those.
You certainly do. You certainly do. So a nice turnaround for Storm Panther. And interesting that if you saw there, the most obvious glaring thing when it comes to light artillery brass is like, oh, there's red smoke here. I should probably not be here. What actually happened is Storm Panther, unintentionally or not, timed it with a tiger shot. So as the tiger shot land, you see the puff of smoke that comes up, the puff of white smoke. He used the light arty barrage, and the red smoke was actually covered by the mist coming up from the snow. So it was a lot harder to spot. I mean, it was half as hard again to spot. So normally the red smoke coming up is very obvious, with the white cloud coming up from the snow is much less obvious, which is why we saw a late dodge from Aihito, because he missed the initial smoke coming up from the light arty barrage. That was cool.
Now, I want to go on a Dathree rant here, and I know people get triggered. So, the whole, like, cartoony, cel-shaded, goofy art style in Dathree that everyone's mad about, myself included, the justification for that, at least the one that they have given publicly, is that they want to improve visual clarity. They want to make it as easy to see what's happening and as easy to understand what's going on, so you can identify and you know, be able to comprehend it. But actually, I think it's the opposite. Like, when I see that the footage, it's just a massive clusterfuck of things happening, and it's hard to really follow. Whereas in Code 2, which has this kind of realistic looking, this beautiful art style, it's very easy to make out what's happening. I was able to make out that it was a sniper which killed the sniper. It wasn't an arty shell. So, like, I just don't understand why they are going for that. At least I can't believe that that justification as it's a way to improve visual clarity, because Code 2 and Dawn of War 2, visual clarity is not a problem. In fact, I think they do it absolutely fantastically. Their presentation is gorgeous. It just feels like the direction, the reasoning for going for this cartoony, bright, wacky art style is just to look like League of Legends, because it's, you know, the multiplayer is basically, it's MOBA style. Still obviously RTS, but it has MOBA elements, and they want to kind of have that, the recognition or appeal to League of Legends players. Like, I don't know. But visual clarity, I don't buy it. I don't understand why that's a reasoning. It makes no sense.
Stupid buzzword, so, yeah. Super Panther, that's actually very intelligent, the MG Bunker. He's so low on squads. It's not possible, as I said earlier in the game, for him to hold two VPs. It's just, you have to split up too much stuff. But by leaving just the MG Bunker down the south, it's a relatively small manpower investment, and it's going to stop that sneaky cap coming in from Aihito. So he's going to have to actually move a tank down there or move an AT gun down there in order to take the VP. So splitting off a lot of forces to essentially just deal with an MG bunker, which was a small initial investment from Aihito. So very smart until he can build up his squad count and maintain double VP control. Definitely what he needs at 92 VPs compared to the 402 of Aihito.
So we have the Brens, that's going to give good trading here to these Tommies. Still a lot of munitions as well, so the Tulips are an option. This Tiger has to be careful. Cromwell, Firefly, 6-pounder, there's actually a couple of Piats too. Actually, I say good visual clarity, but you can't tell how many Brens there are, Piats there are. But that's more a UI thing. It's like, there should be two icons.
Yeah.
Or like it's some way of signifying what weapons there are. Because same if you have a Bren and also a Shrek, you don't really know that. Which isn't inherently a bad thing, but whatever. So, this Cromwell's a bit low. It's taking a bit of damage here. Heavy machine gun. I get really triggered when people say that the Tiger's bad. When people like, buff the Tiger, it sucks. It's like, it's really not. Okay, Cromwell goes down.
It's all kinds of not sucking.
I mean, I wouldn't say it's better than a Pershing or a King Tiger, yeah. But it's good. It's probably better than the ice too.
It's in a very good spot. If anything, it's probably, yeah. In an ideal world, it's probably even a little bit too strong. In an ideal world of balance where everything is like at a certain level relative to other things, it's like, yeah.
Where you actually have to think about whether or not you want to build a heavy tank rather than just build a heavy tank whenever you can.
So, yeah. And I have indeed told a lie. I neglected to think of Piats, which are now rotating down to the south to take out the MG bunker. Quite a nice flank.
Oh, flame. Oh, see, wow. I didn't know there was a flame. Hey! But look at this clump.
Flame of Piat.
Okay, this is a warning. Trigger, look away. Warning. I'm not a safe space.
Oh, no, don't. Move.
He's still close.
Move! He's still... For the love of God,
okay,
move.
That good, right. good guy flamer.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Yeah. Could have been bad. Good response from the Tiger, though. It does allow a hitter to push back into the center of this map and retake the VP.
That's actually a Panther, so he went full tier 4. That's the light arty barrage. Firefly got hit there by the pack, and then now the Tiger's going in. Taking a bit of damage, however, to the 6-pounder.
Oh, no!
Please buff Tiger. Tiger's so bad.
Tiger bad,
but
please
buff. Late game, not good. Yeah. Jeez.
Panther running in. The 1v1 AT guns Panther.
Okay, well, no, that's the Command Panther.
Ah, right, okay, yeah.
Actually, the OKW yeah. Panther has much better MGs. The MGs on the Vermac Panther are much weaker.
So this was the original way to deal with AT gun setup. Old school. One more shot. This Firefly is going to be going down. Suffering that low fire rate and... Yeah, look, 66 VPs, unless Aikido manages to close this one out on VPs, I don't hold very high hopes for this game.
Yeah, GG. Oh my god, that was just Sturm Panther getting like 4 wipes of this Tiger. Jeez. And it's not entirely like good RNG, like there is also, you gotta criticize Aikido. He did have his quads clumped up, and you can't always... unclump your squads, but a lot of times you can. Like, the best thing to do is if you hold down right click and it creates that line and then that spreads them out
line
generally.
Out, yeah.
Or just not click on points to begin with. So, you do have to criticize the player if they make mistakes, but definitely lucky RNG. But still, well played by Sturm Panther. Also, at the same time, there was also ridiculous wipes from the Cromwell. Like, that was just insane.
Yeah.
That's really the problem, I think.
Stiggy got a wipe. Cromwell
yeah, just too
wipes.
Many wipes.
So, yeah,
I just
way
hate,
too
I hate
many
wipes. Because it's not really a skill thing, is it? It's
no.
just, oh, look, I got a wipe. Which is why I reworked AoE in my mod, so you couldn't wipe all squad with a single shot. But yeah, thanks to Sturm Panther for sending this game in. It was definitely a very back and forwards game. It was a nice cast, actually. I love the late game assault grains. It's like, I need VPs now, because they have the sprint.
Yeah.
You know, they get called in. You can nade, like, if there's a HMG team or whatever it is, so...
Yeah, in all honesty, I prefer a squad of late game assault grenadiers to a squad of late game shocks to go for the crazy VP cap. The sprint's good. That being said, shocks have smoke, but it's so expensive trying to get shocks out late game. Whereas like assault grenades, not that much, like 280 or something.
280. So,
yeah.
They're getting a big buff in the balance preview as well. They're still 280, but their reinforcement cost is going down. They're getting a bit more durability at vet one. The grenades are being buffed too, so will be nice. It's a little bit dangerous that we're buffing this commander, but. The assault grenades are so bad.
Yeah.
Buffing the assault grenades won't really make this commander better because currently they're just ignored. People just don't build them, at least in competitive 1v1 play. You always get noobs that spam them in 4v4s, but it generally doesn't work too well. So, yeah, that'll wrap us up. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this cast. If you have any good high-level Company of Heroes 2 replays that you think would make an exciting, interesting, entertaining cast, then please do send them in. And, yeah, we'll see you next time.